So if you ever have the need to take screenshots on your Mac, the macOS Mojave has the first major update to that functionality in a long time. Let's take a look. Let's start by going to System Preferences, and in Keyboard Shortcuts we can see the screenshots shortcuts, and the first four are very familiar because they're exactly the same, right? You can use Shift-Command-3 to save picture of the whole screen as a file, and then you've got shortcuts for saving to the clipboard, saving a selected area to a file or a selected area to a clipboard. But now we have a fifth command, and then basically replaces the first four. You could still use them if you want, but the fifth one, Screenshot and Recording Options, is simply Shift-Command-5. And this is what happens when you use it. Shift-Command-5, and it brings up this control strip here at the bottom, and you have lots of options. So you've got the option to capture the entire screen. You've got the option to capture a selected window. You've got the option to capture a selected portion of the screen. All the options we had before, but now it's really clear to what you're using. You don't have to remember all the keyboard shortcuts. Just Shift-Command-5 is the only one you need to remember, and then you have these options here. In addition, you could also do screen recording from here. Now you could have done that before with QuickTime Player, and it's still available in QuickTime Player, but you can use it right here. You can record the entire screen. That's going to give you a video recording, or you can record a selected portion of the screen. Now we've got even more options here. Just click on Options and there's a bunch of things. You could set where the screenshot is going to be saved to. So you can save it to the desktop. You can select other things here. You can select other location and choose anywhere you want to save it. You could set a timer for 5 or 10 seconds. This is really useful if you want to capture some sort of action that you can't kind of do the screenshot and then do the action at the same time. Like if you need to hold down a key to see something, or if you need to bring up a menu, then you can say 5 second delay, start the screenshot, get everything like you want, and then it captures it. Then you've got other options like whether or not to show the floating thumbnail when it's done, and I'll show you that in a second. Remember the last selection for selecting part of the screen, and whether or not to show the mouse. Then you've got a big capture button. So once you've selected these options, you can go with what you want. So let's go and say let's capture the entire screen. Click that and I'll hit capture. Now look at the bottom right here. That's that floating thumbnail I was talking about, and if you click it, it will open it up and give you all of the markup tools. So you've got the ability to draw on it, to add text to it, all sorts of things, and crop it as well using the crop tool here. You can view it to see whether or not it's what you want. Now you have commands here in the top right. You can throw this away. If you didn't get the screenshot you wanted, you can trash it. You could simply hit done and it will continue to save the file to where you want it to. And you can hit the share button. Share button allows you to actually share this out without ever saving it as a file. So if you just want to send it as an email, you could do that and not have this file left over on your desktop or in some folder somewhere. So you have all the ability to do this. It's great. You can quickly mark something up. So let's just hit done here and you can see it's going to actually save it here. I actually have 3 screens on my Mac, so that's why you get 3 screenshots like that. So let's try it again. I'll do Shift-Command-5, but this time I'm going to bring up a Finder window. Shift-Command-5. I'm going to say I want to select a window. Now I can click on the window to select it, and there it appears there at the bottom. If I wait long enough, it just saves it as a file, so I don't have to click here to do anything. But once I get it, now I can go and do like a markup. I can put a circle around something. I can, you know, create an arrow and move it somewhere. You know, change its color. And then I could go out and share it. I could crop it if I need to further crop it to something else. Or just hit done and now it saves it out and now I've got that file just like I had before. So great screenshot shortcuts. You don't have to remember which one of those ones did what you want. Just Shift-Command-5 and you've got everything laid out there in front of you. This is just a really handy thing. The other thing I want to point out is you do still have the option to save to clipboard rather than to save it to a file. It's just one of these save to options here. And you can also say I want to always go directly to mail. So if you have some sort of task where you're just constantly taking a screenshot and sending it an email, you can set it up as mail, or you can set it up in messages, or you can have it just open up in preview. So I can set it here and it automatically opens up the document in preview here. It doesn't go to the little thumbnail there at the bottom right. Tons of options. Really well expanded, and Of course, let's not overlook the video option as well. So I can record the entire screen. Hit record. I can set which display. Since I have three displays, I'll do this one. And you can see I got the little stop button there to stop recording. There's the movie file. It started saving it. I'll hit stop recording and now it opens it up in QuickTime Player when I'm done. These are great new screen capture options. It's pretty much equivalent to a screen capture type of app that you may buy, but now it's just built into the operating system.